With all the distractions in life these days, it's hard enough for people to get the amount of sleep they need, let alone good quality sleep.
Oh geez, when I sleep, it's probably for 4 hours max, honestly.
Because it takes me longer to fall asleep because my eyes are hurting. I don't know if that's weird, but it's true. And I just feel like my brain's always like active. Like, just I'm always like, oh, like I gotta go check Facebook. I don't know, it's like wired in my head.
Especially if like somebody's saying something on Twitter that I wanna hear, like there's like a little conversation or something going on or a trending topic. I wanna see everybody's comments. So, you know, I might check it a couple times before I go to bed.
High on the list of bad habits, experts say, is watching TV just before retiring. An even harder habit to break for some is late-night texting. That's a no-no, as is using any other type of social networking before sleep. According to the National Sleep Foundation, 38% of people say they use a social networking site within an hour of bedtime. So why is this not a good idea?
When one wants to sleep, one's mind should be quiet. When you engage in things like texting and engaging in social media, your mind is revved up and you have a lot of thoughts that are often racing through your head and you're trying to be very responsive and engaging. And that's exactly the opposite of what you should try to be doing when you want to fall asleep.
What else is keeping us up at night? Eating and drinking habits before bed can also affect the quality of sleep.
In general, we advise patients not to eat right before bed, predominantly because depending upon the food that they ingest, it can lead to things like nocturnal reflux or nocturnal heartburn that can be very disruptive towards sleep.
On the food front, most of us know coffee, tea, and Coke have caffeine that keep us tossing and turning, but other foods do too. Like chocolate and anything mixed with it. And don't be fooled by alcohol.
Alcohol, as I think most people know, if you drink to a certain extent, you feel sleepy and it will cause you to fall asleep more rapidly. But what happens is that alcohol wears off in your system, you'll start to wake up much more frequently, and in fact, at the end of the night, you'll have a very fragmented sleep.
Also, steer clear of doing any form of exercise close to bedtime.
We generally advise patients to not exercise within 4 hours of bedtime because, again, it increases your metabolic rate and it's just harder to fall asleep. That being said, exercise is a very important component of general health, and certainly when you exercise, you are more tired when you go to bed, and that will facilitate sleep.
Food, technology, physical activity, stress can all act as stimulants, preventing the restful sleep the body needs to restore and repair itself and ward off disease. Good sleep requires scrubbing and scouring away stimulants and practicing what's known as sleep hygiene.
Sleep hygiene refers to a combination of sleep habits coupled with your sleep environment. And in our modern society, what's happened is that we tend to use the bed as an office. So people will come to us and say, you know, doctor, I can't go to sleep because I have thoughts racing throughout my head and it goes on for several hours. Well, what's really going on is that they don't associate the bed with sleep. So as soon as they go to bed, suddenly their mind is racing about all the activities that they did during that day.
In addition to avoiding most physical and mental activity, sleep experts recommend enhancing the bedroom environment to make it cool, dark, and quiet.
One of the most important things is really viewing the bed as a place where you sleep or use it for intimacy and for nothing else.
And the best thing for us to do is go to bed and wake up at the exact same time each and every day. The more consistent, the better.